Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to explain the last part of finding the upper bound and lower bound of two unknowns. So if you are given a fraction a over b with a equal to 6 and b equal to 3, so to get the upper bound and lower bound of a over b, you will have to get the upper and lower bounds of a and b. Now, in order for you to get the upper bound of a over b, you will need to use the upper bound of a divided by the lower bound of b. I will explain to you why this is so, okay? But for now, let us substitute the values in. So you have 6.5 divided by 2.5. It's 2.6. Now, why do I want to divide by the lower bound of b? Well, to give you an example, let us do the alternative. If we were to divide by the upper bound of b, I will have 6.5 divided by 3.5, and that will give me 1.857. And clearly, this 1.857 is smaller than 2.6. And as such, it cannot be the upper bound of a over b. Well, to get the lower bound of a over b, can you guess what do you need to put in for the numerator and the denominator? You will need to substitute the lower bound of a divided by the upper bound of b, and that will give you 5.5 divided by 3.5, and that's 1.57. Again, I shall explain to you why we have to divide by the upper bound. So if you were to divide by the lower bound of b, what you will get is 2.2, and clearly 2.2 is not as small as 1.57. And because of this, we want to divide by the upper bound of b. So to write down the answer as a statement, right, a over b will lies between 1.57 and 2.60. Alright, I hope this video will clarify the concept on how to find the upper and lower bounds of a combination of two variables. Now, before we close this video, I will give you one example. A plus b over c, where a is equal to 6, b is equal to 3, and c is equal to 2. Pause the video and give yourself some time to work through the answer. Alright, I hope you have got the answer by now. Let us go through this solution together. So, the first step is always to write down the upper and the lower bounds of the individual variables. So, a is 5.5 and 6.5, b is 2.5 and 3.5, and for c, you will have 1.5 and 2.5. So, you can see that in order to get the upper bound of a plus b over c, you will need to get the upper bound of the numerator first. So to get the upper bound of the numerator, you will need to find the upper bound of a plus b, which is 6.5 plus the upper bound of b, which is 3.5, and that will give you 10. And to get the upper bound of a plus b over c, you will need to use the lower bound of the denominator. So to combine them together, I will need the upper bound of a plus b over the lower bound of c, and since we have already obtained the numerator, okay, which is 10, so the denominator will be the lower bound of C, which is 1.5. Okay, so we have 6.7. Well, similarly, to get the lower bound of A plus B over C, I will need to use the lower bound of the numerator, which is the lower bound of A plus B. So I will have 5.5 plus 2.5, and that's 8.0. And to get the lower bound of a fraction, remember, you will need to divide the denominator by the upper bound of C. So to conclude, you will have to take the lower bound of A plus B divided by the upper bound of C, and that will be 8.0, 2.5, and that's 3.2. Alright, so lastly, again, we want to write down the answer as a statement. So that will be 8.0 and 3.2. That's it. I hope you have a clearer understanding. And remember to work through the worksheet that's attached to this video to show that you have understood.